the government. So you can do it yourself. You don't have to depend on government for class actions. So you all know. But see, the shift here is from, you have all learned under Sale of Goods Act, there is a principle called caveat emptor. Right. But now it has changed with Consumer Protection Act, it is caveat venditor. Seller be aware. Okay. Buyer need not be aware. Okay. We are, you know, transforming ourselves, not completely, to some extent, that now seller also has to be aware. He cannot take all of us for a ride. Okay. I have already mentioned this. Now, this is what is important. How can class actions be filed under Consumer Protection Act? One, any voluntary registered consumer association. Now, this is from the provisions of the Act. I'm not, you know, giving anything which is not there in the Act. It's under the, I'm just not taking you into the sections and all of that. But this is one, any voluntary registered consumer association, NGO, can file a class action. Second, central government or any other state government can also file a class action for representing people, right? Union of India filed class action consumer complaint against Nestle for sale of Maggi for rupees 640 crores on grounds of unfair product and sale of defective goods, right? Now, this is where actually there is a lot of work done by people in United States. In fact, those of you who are interested can watch the movie Class Actions. There is a movie called Class Action, okay? Beautiful movie where they have, you know, shown how a class action is used against a giant manufacturer of car, right? By simple consumers. So one or more consumers, where there are numerous consumers having the same interest, right? This is where I think the great power of any one person, okay, who has same interest with others, and there are numerous persons who are, let us say, using the same product or availing of the same service, can combine themselves and file a class action, right? Just a simple thing. Many a times, you know, we ignore, or as Madam said, that some dress was bought and it was not exchanged. Many people face all these types of things, but they don't want to, you know, go to the consumer forum and file a case and fight it out. And therefore, many of these injustices go ignored, okay? We don't want that, we don't want to take that trouble of, you know, for example, you go to some shop where prices which are written in the MRP are different and what you, they charge is much more than that. Now there is a 2 rupees or 3 rupees or 4 rupees difference. You don't have, you know, the motivation to fight that 2 rupee, 3 rupee case anywhere, and therefore the shopkeeper is fine. You know, he is charging 3, 4 rupees from hundreds of such people and he gets wealthy like this in an unfair manner. Okay. Now, an intelligent class action consumer activist, what he can do is, if he finds that these types of things are being done by any trader, any manufacturer, any service provider, he can try and combine, okay, similarly situated persons and then file a class action in the consumer forum. Or only file one and the consumer forum is requested to issue notice in public, in media, and invite people who are similarly cheated. Now, if that happens, I'm sure that shopkeeper, that manufacturer, that service provider will immediately surrender. Okay?